Let's get right into it, shall we? Let's start with the worst story. So, and we're referencing, the particular article that we're referencing is from CNN, about a mother of a seven-year-old with autism who filed a lawsuit after a resource officer handcuffed her son at school. Can you see where I'm going with the anger here?
And pinned him to the ground, a seven-year-old.
Yeah, and a lot of times now, stories will post a link to the body cam footage. And I, you know, I'm somebody who should not watch the body cam footage because, you know, I don't handle it well. And I didn't handle it well. And I want to caution people, you know, that you don't need to see it unless you need to see it. But man, am I mad. Man, am I mad, and I want this mom to know that I stand with her on this, and I have a lot to say about it, but let's hit some particulars. You know that I tend not to want to say names, especially of the younger person that is involved in this, and I'm not going to say the name of the officer because I don't want to get into like vindictiveness against one person, although I'm pretty upset with this officer. This is from... it's in North Carolina, the city of Statesville. And it was a Statesville police officer who was serving as a school resource officer at the Presley Alternative School. Let's say the names of those places. And the boy was enrolled in a day program there, has a diagnosis of autism spectrum disorder. And he was enrolled in this school because they are affiliated with a nonprofit behavioral and mental health provider. Okay. And then I don't know exactly what happened before, and I want to acknowledge that. And I don't think Nancy knows exactly what happened before, but what we're told is that the boy was spitting.
Yeah.
And I just want to pause there for a second and say that this was in 2018. This wasn't even in COVID. So in 2018, this boy was spitting. And, you know, I don't know what led up to the fact that they called in this resource officer who's supposed to apparently keep the peace and keep behavior well. But this guy, who is no longer on the police force, according to local reporters, he quit. Gosh, you think? Right before he was going to get fired and sent to jail. This happened on September 11th, 2018. Okay. So did you happen to see the video, Nancy, or did you spare yourself?
I did not look at the video.
Well, good for you, but it doesn't show what led up to it. So we have to keep reiterating that. However, I've worked in a classroom, former teacher, have dealt with, and you and I have both dealt with seven-year-olds who are on the autism spectrum, both of us. And to be fair, both of us have gotten injuries. You know, we've been scratched. I've been bit. I think you have too. You know, so we understand what a seven-year-old on the autism spectrum can do. There were, in the video, it starts and there are two people holding him down while the officer is talking to him and talking to him in this very calm way and saying the most insidious stuff about, are you familiar with the juvenile delinquent system? Well, you're going to get familiar today, aren't you? And he said, you're going to be charged.
Yes, he also threatened the boy by saying, after he put him in the kneeling position with his arms pinned behind him, said, if you spit on me, I'm going to put a hood on you.
Yes, you're absolutely right. He said that. I stood up and yelled at the video when that came up. I was so mad. Mm-hmm. And when they're putting the handcuffs on him, he's very calm. They're able to put the handcuffs on and then they lower him to the floor. And here's the thing, there's two people who are sort of, one who's help holding him down to get the handcuffs on, and somebody goes and gets a pillow for him. And they lay him on his stomach on the pillow And then the officer, Mr. Wonderful, says, "Are you okay? Can you breathe?" And then sits there and talks to him about, I don't know, sports and all this other stuff. But every once in a while says, "Well, you know, you've met the wrong person. You're not going to get away with this kind of BS." In this very kind of, you know, I'm a nice guy sort of way. I think it's something, it's over 28 minutes that he laid there on the floor with his face on a pillow until his mother got there and lost her mind. And you see, mm-hmm. you see in the video, because it's all edited, but you see that she's like, you know, and they uncuff him and she immediately picks him up and he, you know, is attached to her and they sit there and she's holding him. And I think every mother can relate to mm-hmm. that pose. And I will tell you that the boy laid there calmly for over 20 minutes and the police officer kept touching him. At one point, the police officer wiped tears off of his face and finally, and he kept like taking his arms and touching his arms. And finally the boy starts to cry and says, "Get away from me, stop touching me." And he's sobbing. He's sobbing. And I, like, that police officer deserves to never be in law enforcement again. But I'll tell you who I'm mad at. And I'm so glad that this mom is suing the school. Because whoever those two people were who stood there and said nothing and didn't call the police on that man, the mom, he has not been able to go back to school. The mom has had to leave her job to homeschool him. I hope she takes that school to the cleaners, because I'll tell you what makes me so mad. And this is where my anger, like, woo, is that I know it's hard. I've worked in school districts before. And I know when you are a person that's there and somebody's doing something, I know it's hard to speak up. But we are charged, if you are working in a school, then you are someone who is known as a court reporter. You are legally responsible to stand up for your kids and to report when someone is doing something that is hurtful to them. And that includes the people you work with. That is a legal bond. And if you don't do it, you are personally legally responsible, and the school that hires you is legally responsible. So I am thrilled that this parent is suing, and that she's not just suing the police department, not just suing that police officer, she's suing the school, and she should be. And that's why I said last night, I was like, I want to drive there and testify for her, because the two people who stood by should feel very badly. And we want to send a message to people that we don't stand by when people are treating our children horribly. We cannot afford to stand by. And
I was really shocked that this school, which is basically a special needs school.
Well, they're affiliated with the program, so they should know better. They should know better.
Yeah, they should know better. That's what I was shocked about.
And you know what, Nancy? Maybe they did know better. And that this police officer was just one of those power-hungry people who was like, I've got a 7-year-old boy. I think I'll teach him a lesson. Right. But the people who were standing there should have said, what are you doing? And, you know, maybe if they were like, okay, he's going to handcuff him for a minute. But when he was saying, I'm going to put a hood on you, when he left him there, whoever went and put the pillow under his face knew it wasn't right. And they stood there and we have to teach the public, you have to pick up your phone and call for backup. And we have to speak up and say, why are you doing this? He was just spitting. And then we need to get people in those classrooms to teach them, what do you do when a child is spitting? And okay, you know, you hired this resource person, but he's not trained to know what you do when a child is spitting. The whole thing makes me so mad I could spit. It's just absolutely, but I think the thing that upset me more than anything else was the people who stood by.
Yeah.
Because we're always going to have people who are ignorant and stupid and abusive in our lives. But what is the saying about, you know, it's not one evil person, it's the 10 people who stand by.
Yeah, that don't do anything.
That's the thing. True. Yeah. And we've all got to steel ourselves. And I know it's hard. It's very hard. But we have to steel ourselves to stand up to this kind of behavior. whether it's in the workplace or on the street corner, when you see something, you have to be willing to stand up. And yes, I know what I'm asking people to do, because sometimes you end up losing your job over it. I'm well aware of that. But you know what? Those people have to be sick to their stomach that they stood there. They know it's wrong. They know it's wrong. We know it's wrong. And I'm glad that that mom knows it's wrong. And I'm glad that she's suing. And I hope she takes them to the cleaners. Horrible. Hey, thanks for watching Autism Live. To subscribe, click here. And if you'd like to check out some more of our videos, click here.